My name is Miguel.
My name is Dario.
And today we're gonna be some geologists, or rather, cook geologists. We're gonna go over the rock cycle, and here we have igneous rocks. Igneous, repeat after me, igneous.
Igneous.
There you go. And igneous rocks are volcanic rocks. They used to be lava. They form from the cooling of molten lava that, you know, inside is the magma. It comes out as lava, it cools off, and it turns into these igneous rocks. As you can see, it's got some crystals. So that used to be lava. And it's a cycle. The cycle keeps going. When these rocks break down into little pieces, the weathering, what do I have here, Dario?
Rain.
The rain, the clouds, the heat, the cold, it breaks them down and they break into little sediments. That's the reason they are called sedimentary. Can you repeat after me? Sedimentary.
Sedimentary.
Excellent. And these little sediments cement together and form layers. There you can see the different layers of sediments that have cemented together over time. Can you see the layers? There you go. Excellent. But it's a cycle. So the cycle keeps going. Over time, these sedimentary rocks go even deeper underground and they change their form. These layers, these sedimentary rocks, undergo plenty of pressure. Pressure. Like there's a lot of heavy weight on the top of them and some heat, because you know that the lower you go, the deeper you go closer to the core of the earth, the warmer, the hotter it is. So it's got some heat and pressure that makes them change their form. So here we have some melted, twisted layer that looks like candy. Marble, it's one of these metamorphic rocks. Can you say metamorphic?
Metamorphic.
Excellent. Hey, Dario, now we know about these rocks. What about making our own rocks at home in the kitchen? Sounds like a plan?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. All we need is these ingredients. They are common ingredients. Don't be overwhelmed with the recipe. What do we need, Dario?
Water.
Very good. Water. A cup and a half of water. Then we need a teaspoon of baking powder. 1 cup and a half of flour. And then 3/4 of a cup of salt. Very easy. In the back, you can see rice, ground coffee, food color, and pretty much anything you can find to recreate crystals and sediments. This is all about experimenting and having fun. I believe we have the perfect consistency. If too sticky, you can add some more flour or a little bit of oil, any type of cooking oil. All right, now we have the Play-Doh. It's time to have fun and recreate all these rocks. I believe, Dario, it's a good idea to start from the igneous rocks. What do you think? Yes? Can you grab some dough, please? There you go. And you can put it over there. You can knead it. There you go. Knead it well. Nice. Put it there. And igneous rocks, because they used to be lava, sometimes they have some dark, rather black colors. That's called biotites. And you can even see them over here. Do you see that, Dario? those dark spots, dark crystals, those are called biotites. And we're gonna recreate them with some coffee. Can you put some coffee in there? It's ground coffee. And don't worry if it doesn't smell good to you, we'll wash our hands. All right, now it's time to knead it, to mix it. Can you mix it? There you go. Can I have some help, please? No, you gotta knead it. There you go. Mix it, mix it. Nice, that's starting to really look like an igneous rock. Remember that they form from the cooling of molten lava, and the deeper they form underground, the more crystals they have. You know what? We can recreate the crystals with some rice. Can you put some rice in here, Dario? Grab some rice. There you go. That's good. Excellent. Plenty of crystals. That means that it forms very deep underground. There you go. You put the crystals and now knead it. Mix it. Perfect. There we have our granite. It really looks like granite with all these biotites and the silicates, like quartz. The rice represents the crystals. There you go. Nice. Can you see them? Yes. Nice. So there we have our igneous rock. Excellent. Now what happens with them? Over time, the weathering, all these sediments, all these minerals are gonna break down, and they're gonna turn into the sedimentary rocks. So, as you remember, Dario, now we need to make layers. Can you grab little pieces of rock? There you go. We're gonna put this one over here, and we need different rocks, and we're gonna compact them together, make layers, Dario. Layers, 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 layers. All right, you can put it, nice, there you go. We can make more layers. You know, some thousands of years go in between, but that's how they form. Excellent, Dario, can you make another layer? There you go. Nice, that's a nice sedimentary rock, beautiful. You know what? I got an idea. Because the layers form from different minerals, what if we make one of them in a different color? I got some food color. Can you put some food color over here, Dario? Nice. There you go. And now, can make our orange layer. Mix it. There you go. Mix it. Nice. There we go. You see the layers? What if we make a blue layer? Yeah? That's a great idea. Can you put some blue food color over here? Nice. Mix it. Nice sedimentary rock. I love it. I like it. Beautiful. Looks like a hamburger, right? All right. There we go. We have our sedimentary rock. What if we make our metamorphics? The ones that change the... They take a different form. So for that, what if we put different colors? Can you pour some of that food color in? There you go, nice. Good. And why not green? Nice. Why not red? Do you want to mix it? What a cool metamorphic rock. That's okay, we'll wash our hands. And you can see that these same layers over time with plenty of heat and pressure, they turn into the metamorphic rock. We have just created these three types of rocks with these ingredients, but I bet you can get creative and find some other ingredients. Then we have the igneous with our crystals, the sedimentary with our layers, and there we have our metamorphic with those twisted, melted layers. I hope you enjoy it and be creative. Create your own. You don't have to stick to these ingredients. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.